What's going on, guys? So I'm back with another RMT club exercise. We went over underhanded barbarian swing, the last one. This exercise, we're gonna go over the double golf swing, all right? Now, like I always say with RMT club exercises, great for anybody looking to develop power and acceleration in any of their swinging sports, but especially for my golfers with this one, because what it's gonna do is it's gonna let you train that torso range of motion in the mid-back, right? But it's also gonna let you train the acceleration and the deceleration phases of your golf swing. But these exercises can also be applied to your baseball bat swing, your tennis racket swing, for my hockey players out there. You can also apply this to a lot of your boxing sports also. So even though we're gonna be talking about this in relation to a golfing training, a golf-based exercise, you can really apply this to any of your swinging-based sports, all right? So for all my golfers out there, definitely wanna pay attention to this one. Now, one thing I will mention, because especially for a lot of my older clients, I know, you know, range of motion and mobility is a concern for a lot of people. The RMT clubs can be purchased at shopwreckmethod.com. I'll put a link to the website at the end of this video, but they have different weights. We're gonna be utilizing a 4-pound club right now. I usually train with a 6 or an 8-pound club. I'm being lazy, I'm doing the 4-pound video so I don't look shitty in the video. Gotta make myself look good, right? But you can also get 2-pound clubs. And if your balance or your range of motion or just an old injury is a concern of yours, they go for about $99 to $110 each. Go with the 2-pound club. You can always go heavier anyway. If you're looking to train for your golf swing and your club is a matter of ounces, training those same motions with a 2-pound club is gonna put a ton more power behind your swing, all right? So don't feel like you have to go for the heaviest club yet. I'm a big guy, I weigh 260, I do a ton of powerlifting, I do a ton of weight training. I typically use a 4 or a 6-pound club. I use the 8s for certain exercises, but I also use the 2-pound clubs for certain exercises. You don't need a lot of weight for these exercises, right? So I'm gonna go over a couple reps of what the exercise looks like, and then we're gonna bring it down Barney style, give you the bullet points of what you wanna focus on, and show you how you can integrate it into your own routine right now, right? So. Biggest thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna start choked up on the handle so I have room to put that second hand on there, right? All right, cool. So. Now I'm a little tight today, so that probably looked like garbage, but you got the idea of what's going on. Let's take a look at what's going on with that exercise, right? So, like I mentioned, first and foremost, you eventually wanna put both hands on the club, right? Because with golfers, you need that range of motion with both arms on there. If I'm doing a cardio exercise session, right, I'll typically do it without the second hand, so I get more torso activation and more stretch in my obliques, but that's also just training the exercise based on your desired training effect, right? So I'm gonna start in a freedom stance, right? Freedom stance because standing like the Statue of Liberty, up top because you wanna create acceleration on the way down. You'll notice when I start, right? Where's my head? My head's over foot. Head over foot alignment, gold dot, green dot. If you drop the line from the back of my skull out through my chin, that line would go straight down between the knuckle of the two outside toes of my foot, right? Gold dot, green dot alignment. We'll do a video on that later. Just know that it's key for increasing performance and eliminating back pain, right? So step number one, my head's over my foot, downward swing, right? Where's my head? My head's over my left foot. I went from the right foot to the left foot. Two, as I go back overhead, I reload, I grab the club, I bring my head over my right foot again, and now from there, I execute my swing. Heads over the left foot. You can see how I went head over the right, head over the left, head over the right, head over the left. Now, let's look at what's going on with my feet. What are my heels doing? Heels away all day. I'm flaring my heels out. So as I flare my heel out, it causes my hip to rotate in. So this way I can load the glute muscle on this side right here, right? So I'm here, head over foot, let momentum take it overhead. Head over foot, I swing, and then when I get to the end, I like to hold it for a second because you wanna get good at creating force and then stabilizing and absorbing force. So you don't wanna do a golf swing and then fall over when you're on the field, right? The field, or what's the right term for it? When you're out in the The court? Okay, the course. Thank you. You can tell how much I golf, right? So, I'm here, I'm around, I'm up, and then I hold, I'm watching the ball fly down, right? So I'm holding that acceleration. I'm focusing on the balance point. Try driving a car without using the brakes. It ain't gonna work too well. That's why we do it that way. Now, the baseball swing version, for all my baseball players out there, right? I'm using the first swing for a couple reasons. One, I wanna get some shoulder mobility in there. Most people's shoulder mobility is ass, so why not get the extra stretch in there? But it's also gonna give me a chance to, rather than just trying to force it and create momentum myself, I'm just gonna let gravity do the job, right? Create some momentum and then from there, right through. Make life easier for myself. Momentum and gravity doing the work. I'm just controlling the force, right? Now for my baseball swing, right? Instead of swinging downward on the second one, I'm gonna swing outward with the last one, right? So I'm just changing the direction of the second swing. I'm around, I'm up, baseball swing, right? I'm around, I'm up, baseball swing. I'm just changing the direction of my swing. Head over foot alignment applied in both scenarios. Let's go from a side view. I'm gonna go back to the double golf swing first, right? I'm gonna start with my freedom stance, hand choked up so I have room to grab with my free hand, right? Right through. Now, let's go for the baseball modification, right? Activate the obliques, decelerate with the obliques, right? The amount of twisting and torque you're gonna put on those oblique muscles, especially with a baseball swing, you know, the last thing you wanna do is get an injury where you don't train the rotation, more importantly, the deceleration side of it, and end up pulling your shit mid-season, because that's what's gonna put you out. Now, what I really love about the clubs is that you can train different points of the motion. Let's say your acceleration is a weak point. I can really come up, drive down into the club, and really force the acceleration part of it, right? Or I could train the deceleration portion of it. So you can focus on different parts of the motions based on where you need your help. And that's it, guys. Double golf swings modified to a double baseball bat swing, all right? Great for developing power and force into your rotational motions. Also good for developing a sick midsection, right? I hate doing ab exercises. Crunches and sit-ups, I friggin' hate them. Mainly because they bother my lower back. Think about when you train abs. You're designed to be on your feet most of the time, but you do your ab exercise laying flat on the ground, which is one of the reasons why you never feel your lower abs and your hip flexor gets tight, where if I do exercises like this, right, I'm standing, and because I'm standing, I'm able to open up my hips, activate my glutes, I stay out of the hip flexor, I get more lower ab activation, more shoulder blade activation, and I get a ton more motion in my torso. And because I'm doing the rotational motions, I'm getting the obliques, I'm getting the serratus anterior, you know, the little rib cage muscle that's up inside of here. I'm also getting my six pack, right? And then in addition to that, you're gonna get a ton of cardio out of there. So plus it's cool as shit. You're not gonna get bored with this one. Very simple exercise to add in. Double golf swings. We like to use the RMT clubs from the WEC method. You can use Indian clubs. There's modifications where you could use a light dumbbell. I don't recommend it. For my golfers, use a baseball bat. It'll give you more weight than what you're used to. For my baseball players, try that exercise with one or two of your baseball bat donuts on there. They all work the same. So that's all I got for this one. Stay tuned for more fun, filled fitness excitement, because I got a ton of exercises. I've been doing this for 20 years that we're gonna keep pumping out to you guys. Do me a favor, if you like the videos and you're getting a little bit of value out of them, you know, give me a like or a share. It helps us out with the algorithm on Facebook and Instagram, and it gets us out there to help more people. And if there's a topic you have a question on that we haven't gone over yet, do me a favor, drop me a DM. I'm full of ideas, but I also get little brain farts every now and then about as far as what am I gonna put out there today? Suggestions from me, from you guys, gives me the information I need to give you the information you want versus what I think you want, all right? Drink water, stay motivated. See you in the next one.